As Paul Harvey said, this is the rest of the story, and my colleague failed to put the right emphasis on certain issues with respect to the certification. DOD certification was not corruption writ large throughout the entire country of Ukraine. It was narrowly focused on defense institutional reforms and combat capability. Isn't that correct, Ms. Cooper?
That's correct, sir.
First off, Ms. Cooper, thank you for being here this afternoon. I appreciate that. But my colleague seemed to leave that out as original. He read it when we read your statement, but he left off the correct emphasis. So the certification in May didn't really speak to the broader concept of corruption throughout the rest of Ukraine that the president would be familiar with, or the rest of us would be familiar with.
Sir, the May certification was specific to the defense sector, defense industry, and it did reference the importance of civilian control of the military, which relates more broadly to
right, but I think all of us would argue, or none of us, I think, would argue that that fixes corruption throughout the rest of the country. Ms. Cooper, maybe you can shed some light on the specific details. We talk about this the security assistance program, $250 million. Some would argue that because of the pause, that people died in August because of the pause. Can you help us understand exactly what obligated and was there things that were about to be delivered to Ukraine? Was Ukraine out of ammunition? Were they out of javelins? Were they out of all this stuff? And that because of this pause, they didn't get certain lethal equipment that they needed in order to protect their folks during the month of August?
Sir, we will deliver all of the equipment.
I understand. I was trying to get a timeline.
There was no shortfall in equipment deliveries that were expected within that time frame. Obligate means that you're putting the funding on contract.
Okay, and that's contracts.
And you're starting the process.
Yeah, those contracts will be fulfilled fourth quarter, perhaps, or whatever it was.
Sir, I have to say I'm a policy official. I am not a contracting expert, but my understanding is that we will be able to make up for lost time in the contracting process.
Fantastic. You go through three or four steps that you went to because you disagreed with the hold being placed on the assistance, and I certainly agree with that. But did you get any kind of criticism from the folks that you deal with because you were going against the OMB's direction to put a hold on that? Did you get criticized at all for that?
Absolutely not. My entire chain of command was supportive of advocating for removing the hold on the funds.
And you weren't restricted on full-throated advocating on behalf of getting this hold lifted, were you?
No, sir. I faced no restrictions.
Okay. Well, thank you for that. I thought you might be more in touch with the actual specifics of the accounting process, and so I'll defer any further questions. And, again, thank you for being here tonight. I yield back.